I'm glad that the rain didn't keep everyone away, but if you would please stand together this morning, turn in your songbook to number 341, I heard an old, old story. LeFevre Quartet with us, and they're going to bring the message to us in song this morning, and I know that it'll be an encouragement to you and challenge you this morning. And so without further ado, I want you to give a New Hope welcome to the LeFevre.
same old crowd I knew before. When they asked me what had happened, I tried to tell them.
Thanks to Calvary,
I don't come here
of my life.
Good morning, church. How are y'all doing today? Are you sure? Praise the Lord. Well, man, it's an honor for us to be here today. This is our first time in Diana. I told them last, we were in Houston last night, and they said, where are you going tomorrow? I said, Diana. They said, new Diana? I said, I don't know. I don't know if it's new or not. Evidently, there's a new Diana, right? It's the same place. Out with the old, in with the new, right? But listen, we're here. I want to know, I know y'all are seeing us for the very first time, but I want to tell you right off the bat, we're here above all things to lift up our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. He is worthy of our praise. It says in the Word, if we didn't praise Him, He would call on the rocks and the mountains to do it. And I know that's not going to happen here this morning, because He's not going to need those rocks and mountains. Because we as the body of Christ are going to give Him praise. As the body of Christ, would y'all do that this morning? Give the Lord praise. Lord, we love you. When you get saved, there's a difference. Amen. When who I was met who He is. Come and see what Jesus did.
She was 12 years old, the Bible said. When life just stopped and gave her away. In the hands of death, she reached for life. Her mother wept, her father cried, she's dead. But Jesus wrote a different story. Another chance for God to receive glory. He woke her up and took her by the hand, restored to her life again. This is all they heard the young girl say. Come and see Jesus did.
See what
let me ask you, I'm pretty sure of the answer to this question, but how many of y'all are seeing us for the very first time ever? 1, 2, 13, everybody, okay? Well, let me introduce the guys to you real quick. Some of you are still looking at us like a mule looking at a new gate, and I want to introduce the guys to you so you'll know who's singing for you, and we'll be friends from this point forward, I promise you that. To my far right, this guy is amazingly blessed with a beautiful tenor voice. And not only that, he preaches the word of God, but even better than that, he lives it. And I'm thankful he does it right here with the LeFevre Quartet. Would y'all say hello to Jeremy Peace? This is Jeremy. This young man has been with the group since he was 13. He's the ripe old age of 25 now. A little over 10 months ago, he had a baby, and it's the sweetest. His wife had the baby. You know, you have to be tell folks that these days. I watch the news. I know what's happening. Y'all watch the same channel, don't you? But anyway, he is so proud of that young little baby, and his parents are proud of him, and I know that to be true because I'm his dad. Y'all say hello to my son, Jordan LeFevre. This is Jordan. Over the years, I've had the privilege of singing with some of gospel music's greatest bass singers. I believe this guy is no exception to that. He has a beautiful bass voice. I know you'll love him today. Say hello to Keith Plott. And this is our Texas boy. All the way from Dallas. He's born and raised in Dallas and raised there most of his life. And what a talented young man this is. He's got a great testimony, and y'all should be proud to have him from Texas, I tell you. We're proud to have him with us, all the way from Texas. But listen, you bless your heart this morning. Multi-talented, 19 years old, multi-talented. You like that? I don't know what your other talent is, but I just thought I'd throw that in. Made it sound good, didn't it? But y'all will love this kid. Say hello to Josh Townsend.
Christ who came from heaven just to be our Savior. And he saved poor, lost, wretched soul like me.
And oh, what a Savior! Hallelujah! His heart was broken on Calvary.
His hands,
they
songs, then you're missing the point that we came this morning. So I hope you're hearing them. Come on up, brother. Make yourself at home.
All right. I'll act like I've been here before. Amen. Praise the Lord. You enjoy that this morning? We're going to let them take a break, unless their name is Josh. We're going to let him play the piano for us again. But while he's doing that, I want you to get ready for an offering. We want to take up a love offering for these guys because we need the parking room. So if we can get their bus out of here, no, but we want to help them out this morning. And so we're going to take up a love offering for them right now. And we'll take up our regular offering at the end of the service as per usual. But give them a little break. So we want to give you a chance to write out that $1,000 check. And even if you spell their name wrong on the bulletin, like that guy that does the bulletin, it don't matter. I bet it'll cash anyway. But let's have a, guys, come on down if you're ready. And we'll have a word of prayer. Josh will play a song for us on the piano. And then the LeFevres will be back. All right. Brother Ken Johnson, would you ask a blessing on the offering, please?
Dear Jesus, thank you very much for the privilege of gathering together. Thank you for giving us the gift of song and giving so many talent to praise you and for the privilege of listening this morning. Pray that you all bless these funds for your ministry.
Oh,
You know, my family has been singing. They started back in 1921. No, I was not there. But they sing this old song. It says, some people go to church on Sunday and they'll stand up there and shout. But then they go to work on Monday and leave their Savior out. They think they've done their duty and to the Lord they have been true. But they'll find when they reach their judgment that their one day religion won't do. Folks, it's not about religion. It's about a relationship with Jesus Christ. And that's what we need today. That's why I like that song, Walk Every Day With My Lord. When I was a young kid, I say young, I better start that over. When I was younger, my father and I were very close as a child. In fact, my son and I are very close too. When we're off the road, we spend a lot of time together, especially that I got that new grandbaby. I'm pretty proud of that. Is that yours? Oh my. You wouldn't take nothing for him, would you? I tell you what, his name is Jace, and he crawled this week, and boy, we're going to celebrate when we get back home. He's been rolling everywhere he went. Like a little rolling, this thing rolled across the floor. But Jordan and I have been close ever since he could walk and hold my pants leg.
He still does.
Now I'm almost at the age where I have to hold his pants leg. But he says, my father and I had that relationship, and I cherish that. But I remember when I was very young, he went in the hospital for a surgery, and I remember talking to him there in that waiting room. You know, the reason I'm sharing this story with you, because this is real life. And you know, this is something I went through as a child, and I had to deal with as a child. But I remember telling my dad how much I loved him. And as I was walking out of the room, he said something to me that I'll never forget as long as I live. He never held these back, but he told me this time, and it was just special because I just remember it so vividly. But he looked at me and said, I love you too, buddy. Little did I know those were the last words I'd hear him say to me. He didn't make it, and I was devastated. And I'm sure that there's some people in this church building this morning that have had to deal with loss in their life. And loss is a hard thing to deal with sometimes. You may be going through something with sickness in your family, or I've got a friend of mine that's got a mother that doesn't even know who their child is anymore because of Alzheimer's. We all have to deal with these things in life, and there's an old song that says we'll understand it better by and by, and I believe that when we get home, we'll understand all these things. Sometimes it's hard to understand right now. But I think if I could go back, if I had anything else to do, I wouldn't change much, but I know I'd do this one thing. I'd love to tell my dad goodbye. It's not that I wouldn't let him go, but I'd love to say goodbye to him.
He said, I'll call you, hon, when I get there. 10 minutes later, he was in the air. She dropped the kids at school and headed home. Walked in and turned the front room TV on. She could tell if there was something wrong. Every channel had the same thing on. Now 7 years have come and gone away, but she's still hurting like it's yesterday.
She wants to put her arms around his neck and look into his eyes so blue and say, honey, I don't regret a single day I spent with you. She wants to tell him that she loves him so and will until the day she dies. It ain't that she can't let him go. She just wants to say
through her silver hair he runs a comb. He hangs their wedding pictures on the wall. She don't remember who he is at all. He tells her stories about the life they've lived, from their first kiss to their last grandkiss. For 7 months now she just sits and stares, but if she wakes up, he's gonna be right there.
He wants to put his arms around her neck and look into her eyes so blue and say, honey, single day I spent with you. He wants to tell her that he loves her so, and will until the day he dies. It ain't that he can't let her go.
He just wants to say goodbye.
Redemption's cause, and while the empty tomb stands.
Given us different traits and different things that we have to share for the glory of God. And I think ours is singing. I hope. let me tell you something. We live our family. It was tax time recently. We added up how many days we were on the road this past year. 240 days we were on the road this year telling the world that Jesus saves. And we preach the word that in fact it says in God's word that you must be born again if you want to spend an eternity in heaven, and that's just the plain truth. There's nothing fancy about that. But you know, see, that's the beauty of salvation. It's not complicated. It takes a heart, a repentant heart, a desire to serve God. And to allow Him to be the Lord of your life. You know, we as people are, I believe, can be stubborn, especially men. Men, we know what's going on, don't we? We know we don't need a GPS. We know where to go, don't we? And I believe with all of my heart that pride will keep more people out of heaven than anything. Because I guess I'm in a place in my life where I'm not worried about, if I need to get down here in this altar and pray, I'm not worried about what you think about me. What I'm concerned with is my relationship with Jesus Christ. And yet people will sit in their pew or sit in their seat with God calling their name and they won't respond because they're worried about what everybody else thinks. I spent several years of my life, I was raised around gospel music and church, so I went to church and gospel music all my life, and ended up singing back in the 80s with one of gospel music's most popular groups, and we were winning all these awards and everything, and I was up there singing not saved, but I was under conviction. I had somebody ask me, how can you sing not saved? I was under conviction, but I had pride. Here we were winning all these awards and everything was going great. And I was under such conviction. I was going through, oh man, you know that feeling where you know something's wrong. And I had a pastor friend. I called him up. I was just feeling that overbearing weight of the world on my shoulders. And I called him up and he asked me a simple question. He said, Mike, if the Lord were to come back today, would you go to heaven? And I couldn't answer him right off the bat. The first thoughts in my head, well, I've been singing gospel music all these years. I've had experiences where I felt something. But the truth was, I had never surrendered my life to Christ. And I couldn't answer him. And he said, "Buddy," he said, "I love you, Mike." He said, "I love you. I've known you for years. I love you." He said, "But," he said, "you're going to hell." And my heart broke that instant. And I knelt there in my living room with a phone to my ear and I asked Jesus to be the Lord of my life. I prayed. And that prayer is so simple, yet we make it so difficult. And I want to encourage you today. I want to ask you that question that he asked me that day. If the Lord were to come back today, would you go to heaven? Now, I hope everybody in this church building this morning is saved. But there's a good possibility there's somebody like me that's out here that was playing church, just going through the motions. We sang the other morning at a church in Kentucky. A lady had been in church all her life. She was in her mid-40s. She'd been teaching her Sunday school for 15 years. And she came down to the front, surrendered her life to Christ. She said, "I had an experience when I was young." She said, "But I've been living that church life." She said, "But I've never surrendered my life to Christ." That song that says, the man that wrote that song, "I Surrender All," can you imagine where he was in his life when he wrote the words to that song that said, "All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all." He didn't say, "I surrender a half," or "I surrender a third." He said, "All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all." I want to challenge you this morning, if you've never asked Jesus to be the Lord of your life, it says in God's Word, today is the day of salvation. I want to encourage you to set pride aside and take a step for Christ. You may be at a point in your life this morning where you've grown complacent. I believe that complacency in the church is one of the saddest things that's going on in America right now. People are in a habit of they'll go to church, but they're not really experiencing God. Don't be complacent in your relationship with Christ. Man, there's always more. Always more. It's not just the pastors or the music ministry. It's not just his job to get up here and do a pep rally for you. You got to be involved. Sink your heart into what God's called you to do. There may be somebody here this morning that just wants to refresh that time. They remember when they got saved and it's just gotten kind of stale. You want to feel that feeling. You know, Pastor, when I got saved, I heard a pastor say then that this is very true. He said, "When I got saved, I could have attacked hell with a water pistol." Don't you want that feeling again where you're that bold and you're standing for Christ? You like that old song my family used to sing? You stand up and shout at church on Sunday and then go to work on Monday and forget you ever went to church. You got to live it every day. I want to walk every day with my Lord. Amen. I want to challenge you today. If you feel that drawing in your life, today is the day of salvation. I want to say one other thing. There may be somebody here. I've heard Jeremy say it 1,000 times. Behind the smile, a lot of times, a lot of pain. You may be in a place in your life where you're feeling pain. I want to encourage you this morning by telling you this. God loves you. Pastor, come up. We're going to sing a chorus of that old song, "I Surrender All," okay? Jeremy, I want you to do a verse of that. And we're going to sing that chorus. I may be the only one feeling it this morning, but I believe maybe somebody in here needs a touch this morning.
All to Jesus I surrender all.
Would y'all stand?
Us in a time and a place where he puts us so that we would reach out to him, though he is not far from any one of us. He is not far from you. You need to come this morning if you need to do business with God. What a wonderful thing it is that we have a God who wants longs to be reached out to.
All to Jesus I surrender. Humbly at His feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken. Take me, Jesus. Take me. But with Jesus, thank God
this morning, these guys have done a great job sharing the gospel through.